Yeah, for IPL, this year I'm cheering for Pune Warriors, India. See, these are two different format of game. Actually, I don't want to compare Test cricket with IPL because two different atmosphere, two different attitude, two different mental setup. So it's a different format of game. You can't compare IPL with Test cricket. See, obviously, Test cricket is the best form of cricket. But now everything is changing. IPL has got a very big impact on our society and in our cricketing career of the youngsters. So you can't keep aside IPL now. It's a very important part in cricket now. Not IPL, T20. So if you ask me about this never die spirit, I can't reply it properly because it's a sort of nature. He's basically a quiet kind of a guy. His expression is within himself. He don't want to express his expressions and he don't want to share it with other people. But if he wants to do something, he gives his 100% effort to do that thing. That's why whenever he's struggling, he's always out of his struggle. Maybe it takes some time, maybe for 1 month, 2 months, maybe a year, like we have seen previously. But he's out of that because mentally he's a very strong guy. Love for cricket, his passion for cricket, which I have seen. And that is immensely over there. Means from the morning till evening, he only thinks for cricket. Whenever he's eating, he's thinking about cricket, walking about cricket, sleeping, then also he's talking and thinking about cricket. So sort of without cricket, I have never seen him. See, I have left my cricket 10 years back. Basically, I don't think of much cricket now. But I don't think that sort of, even after 10 years from now, still he will be like this. He will keep on thinking about cricket. That is his passion. That is his love. To be honest, if I say that also, that will be a very false statement. He's not at all in a proper good shape because you can't expect somebody at age of 39 who has left his international career 3 years back be in a good shape. But I told you just now that he's mentally very strong guy and his passion, his love for cricket, that's why he's there. That's why whenever he's going out to bat, his opponent is thinking about him. Though they know that his man is out of cricket for 3 years, his man is not physically 100% fit, maybe he's 40% fit. But still, he is Saurav Ganguly, he is there, he is a dangerous man. He is also very, very much cautious about his hairstyle, about his hair. He spent a lot of time maintaining his hair. He has lost his hair, so that's why he is changing his hairstyle to set himself. Yeah, I have seen this kind of same expression when he got Rahul Dravid out in Kolkata, first year IPL, when he was leading Kolkata Knight Rider. He got Rahul Dravid out. And the same kind of expression I've seen. This is not the first time. At home, we only talk about family. Means no cricket, no business, nothing. Because we don't get much time to interact with each other or with my parents or with our children. So whenever we home at night, we have our dinner together and we only chat about other things. Yeah, cricket is there, business is there, but more of other things, less of cricket and all. I think this should be his last year. If you ask me honestly, I think it should be his last year. But definitely he will be involved in IPL with the teams. I don't know which team, as a coach or as a mentor, because his cricket brain is something different. And I think any team should have that much liberty to have his cricketing. The best moment is Saurav getting the man of the match and Chris Gayle and Royal Challengers Bangalore defeating Pune Warriors, because I think that's the best match I've seen in IPL. Chasing 183, Chris Gayle the way he batted, De Villiers the way he batted, and Saurav Tiwari, I think that's the best match. I'm not very hopeful about the future of Bengal cricket. Maybe one Manoj Tiwari is there now. But I don't think, because this year Saurav played, that's why Bengal has done bit better. But next year Saurav won't be there. And only one Manoj Tiwari, I don't think it will help much of Bengal cricket. Because we don't have a infrastructure. The infrastructure I have seen in Rajasthan cricket association or in Mumbai or in Karnataka or in Bangalore or in Delhi, we don't have that infrastructure. Basically, we don't have a good cricket academy. We don't have a very good gym in Kolkata. If you see the gym position in Kolkata in CAB, I think my gym is better than CAB gym. My academy gym is 100 times better than CAB gym. I've got a better infrastructure than CAB as well. My wickets are much better than CAB as well. So CAB doesn't have Bengal cricket have got no infrastructure. See, the people who are sitting in Bengal, who are running this Bengal cricket, they are not interested in Bengal cricket. They are only interested in IPL. They are interested in what matches we are getting from board, how we are making the stadium. They are spending crore in stadium, 100 crore in stadium, but still they are not being able to conduct England-India match, spending so much of money. Forget about that. They are not spending a single money in making a proper gym. What they are doing in Kalyani, I don't know. Because so far I came to know that when they have opened that Kalyani Academy, the infrastructure was not ready at all. So I don't know what is the position now, because I'm not involved in CAB. But I can assure you that infrastructure in Kolkata, in CAB, is very, very poor. The amount of strength they have got, amount of facility they can afford to give, the amount of monetary power they have got, monetary strength they have got, facilities is absolutely zero compared to that.